dear, you're late. Hurry up.
Yep, coming.
We're just making friends with our new boss. Ah, enchanting. Morning, my love.
Evening, darling.
Oh.
Now have your breakfast.
Uh-oh, carrot juice again?
You said it was good for your vision.
One more gallon and I won't need a telescope. Darling, I had a perfectly marvelous night's sleep.
You needn't tell me. I could hear you down here.
Well, you see, a good husband keeps in touch with his wife even when he's asleep. Oh, this bacon is full of charm. Ethel, you have a touch with bacon.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Shall I put these way upstairs?
Oh, no, he'll need them.
On a hot night like this?
Oh, but it's cold up there on the mountain.
Imagine going way up there just to look at the stars.
Don't you ever look at the stars, Ethel?
I did once, but I'm married now.
Ah, oh, what charm. What efficiency. What glamour. What a face.
Oh, I only hope she likes us. This is an upside-down house for any maid. At sunset, you have breakfast. An hour later, I have dinner. You come home when I get up.
Don't worry about the maid, darling. She's crazy about me. Vicky, shall I tell you something?
I've never been able to stop you.
Ha-ha. Well, no matter how repulsive I may look, particularly when having breakfast, I'm feeling especially attractive this evening. Oh,
then what a pity you can't stay home.
Oh, I'll have a few days off just as soon as this comet business is over.
You've said that before.
Yeah, but this time it's in the bag, because I know now that my calculations are exact. Our comet's going to make astronomical history.
Oh, my clever little man. My clever little astrologer.
Oh, Vicky, darling. Scientist, mathematician, physicist, bacon eater, yes, but not astrologer.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Darling, astronomy and astrology may sound alike, but that's all. Astronomy is a science. Astrology, superstition.
But aren't you a little bit intolerant? For thousands of years, astrology has been highly respected.
Astrology, my love, stinks.
See? You can answer it.
Well, I'll work on it. Now, where's my pipe? Vicky, after our comet does its stuff, suppose we go away for a vacation.
Huh. I know your vacations, thank you. Remember Phoenix?
Don't rub it in. I was overworked.
We were going to do everything together. And what happened?
Well, I was tired.
I'll say.
Where should we go? Huh?
I'm thinking.
It becomes you, my love.
Let me see. You haven't been home one single night in 9 weeks.
What about New York? Or Palm Springs? I know. A little shack up on Mount Ross.
You know something? My idea of a really nice vacation would be to stay right here.
What, not go away, not move?
Oh, it would be nice just for a change to have breakfast with my husband and dinner and... You think I'm exacting? Do off you go.
Hey, you're trembling.
Would you rather I froze? Oh, don't go to the observatory tonight. Stay home.
If I only could.
Here's your lunch, Mr. Professor. I put in a fresh tomato.
Gosh, thanks.
Oh, no more kissing. And never with that cap on.
Holy smokes, that's six.
Oh, well, the stars have been there for a long time. They can wait.
They can wait. Like me.